There we go. How's it going, everybody? Everybody out in YouTube land. I hope you're all doing well tonight. My name is Carpo, in case you don't know me. I imagine with my videos, at least a couple people come in, you know, new people come in on each video. It must be. It was weird back in the old days. I could make a video and like 10 people would watch it and I'd answer like one or two comments and be like, cool, we had like a little family. And then the family got bigger and bigger and bigger and exploded to what it is today, which is still not huge, but I'm on the verge of not being able to answer comments. And it's kind of sad because I really like people and I enjoy commenting and conversing. I just don't have the time between, you know, working and family and everything else. And that's what I'm here to talk about is myself. So that's my warning. I'm going to talk about my own life here a little bit. And I thought, you know, I was in the house and I was going to come out here and talk about something specific. And I thought, you know, I don't ever talk about my own life. And the truth is, this is cathartic for me. This is a release or a kind of a visit with a psychiatrist, if you will. When I sit down here and I bounce ideas off of YouTube and post them to the world. And, you know, there's sure to be people with different opinions, and I welcome that. I very much enjoy discussing various topics, but I never talk about my own life. You know, it's not very much, anyway. But, well, if you're wondering, I'm just a normal dude. There's nothing really to talk about. I mean, I've got, I love my life. I have a wife and two young kids and one older son. My kids are 5 and 8 and then 23. He just turned 23. And it's just crazy. It's been a wild ride, you know. I've had some harsh times in my life. My father died when I was 15. And then, you know, we moved around a lot when we were young. And then afterwards, even. And life comes and goes with its moments of stress and understanding. And, you know, I don't know. It's funny, because in the last couple days, I've actually felt really, I don't know, I've been taking chaga, and I think that chaga is definitely having an effect on me, and it's funny, because I don't ever want to point out a specific herb or mushroom that may be helping, because it takes a while to really see what works, but chaga seems to have a clarity that I haven't found before in a mushroom, and being the greatest antioxidant in the world, I guess that makes sense, but I'm still very wary about claims made from herbs and substances. Like kratom users know that if you take kratom, you can tell if it works or not. If you have it for take it for pain, if it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know, cannabis, if you smoke it and you don't get anything, well, you don't get anything. And but when it comes to more, you know, mild herbs, that where people say, here, take this, it's expensive, but you have to take it for a month or more to feel effects, you're like, I don't know, I'm a little bit wary of that one. But, you know, I'm not perfect. I try to be as healthy as I can, but I vape. I'm cool with it. It's kind of a trade-off, you know. It makes me feel guilty and unhealthy sometimes. But at the same time, I'm like, well, I quit smoking after 25 years. There's my justification, you know. I'm not here to, In my life, I'm not trying to, I guess, justify myself, but rather justify myself to myself, if that makes sense. And it seems like most of us, you know, to one degree or another, we do that. We justify our actions, our expenditures, like buying yourself that new phone. I deserve it. That type of mentality. And, you know, it's funny because in the Western world, it seems like people would say, well, you know, we've got it pretty easy. Let's say people in the U.S., you know, pretty easy. You can kick back, you know, have a lot of time and relax, say what you want, all these rights. But even with all that, and of course a lot of people would say, no, it's the opposite. You have no rights. But, you know, the reality is we as Americans do have freedom of speech, whether you like it or not. I mean, people say, well, people get killed for saying things. Sure, but I can sit here and say whatever I want, you know. Fuck the government. I can say anything I want in this video, and it may get pulled, it may get noticed, whatever. It's not like I'm going to have the Gestapo busting down my door because I talk bad about the president. And that's the one thing that sets our country apart from other countries. Although that is changing, and anything can happen at any moment. I'm not in denial. I realize that this, I know the corruption and the extent of it, but there are a few, the point being that there are a few things that I should be grateful for, that I have, and one of those is the platform, I guess, to talk about things, and so here I am, you know, on YouTube, making videos and talking about life, but Nat, I remembered now, full circle, what I was talking about originally was, well, God damn it, brain fart, how that affects our daily life. Let me think. How do I word this? I guess I'll just let it go because it's pointless. It's one of those things that if I was an editor, I'd probably edit out of my videos, but I don't give a fuck. And I don't give a fuck. And that's what I enjoy about being me. I don't give a fuck what other people think, but I still have enough conscience to understand that if I don't have any respect from people, if I'm a complete douchebag, it doesn't matter how much I love myself or, you know, think I'm right, that I don't mean I love myself. I mean, no matter how much I would, you know, it doesn't matter if other people don't give you approval. You know, all of that's meaningless. Most people know that, you know, deep down in their hearts. That, you know, if I was making videos talking about life and opening up my heart and people were saying, you know, just constantly beating me down and harshing on me, I would probably not even be on YouTube. And I've seen people on YouTube that's happened to. And this is usually partially their doing because they get into fights with people. You know, there was a guy years ago named Mac, and he was just the worst dude on YouTube in our group. And a bunch of people got into some, it was back when I was into occult mysticism and, you know, I don't consider it dark. I was really into the white, the light, the understanding, the wisdom. And it was my manly P. Hall days when I was really into occult knowledge, which just means hidden. But it had nothing, you know, people started calling me a Satanist and all this shit. And I backed away from it. I'm like, I'm not going to argue with you about it. Well, a couple other people really took the bait and took it too far. I mean, I think even in one case, a guy got ended up calling the cops on someone, and they came to their house or something. It was, like, crazy. And I'm like, why does it have to come to this? You know, we're just people. Just let it go. Let your ego fucking go. But these people were so obsessed with it. I was like, I was so bummed out. Anyway, this has happened in a few different channels that I've watched where people have gotten thrown out because people harshed them and they couldn't handle it. And I think, well, you know, people don't berate others unless it's either a controversial subject or the person's a complete asshole, you know. And some people are assholes, but most people just talk about controversial subjects, and those are the ones that get the most views. Because I'll tell you, most people don't get onto, you know, YouTube every morning and get in the search box and type the newest yoga spiritual practice, or the newest understanding about the self, or, you know, the greatest brain chemistry discovery. No, it's usually the Illuminati, or what's happened with the New World Order, or reptilians, or something like that, Alex Jones, and people just jump on this stuff, and they're in this negative news headspace where they're just sucked into it. You know, somebody said something on my Kratom video the other day about the potential ban, which I'll make another video about. I'm not really worried about it, but we'll see what happens. Another subject altogether. Damn it. See, I did it again. I totally spaced what I was going to say because I got distracted. Anyway. Brain fart. It's weird. I have too many thoughts on my mind, and I'm trying to race through them all, you know? And I took a bong hit earlier. That didn't help. So, YouTube has always been an outlet for me, and when I was into these occult things and talking about them, I had a lot of people harshing me too, and I walked away from it. I actually extended my hand to a guy privately through a message, private messages and email saying, hey man, you know, hey, dude, I'm sorry you feel this way, and I'm sorry you think that I'm some crazy Satanist and claim I'm all these things. I mean, people will berate you and call you names and project on you things that they're fearful of. I mean, child molester or murderer. I had one guy who was talking about drugs, and he was calling me a murderer because I didn't support his drug pro-drug crusade. It was against... It was like to end the drug war. I think the guy's channel was End the Drug War on YouTube years ago. And I was like, he was just the harshest dude I'd ever seen, you know? And I thought, some people are so pissed off. You know, it's just not worth it. It's not worth it to fucking be miserable in your life. And you can tell when people are miserable. You know, they want to project that onto you, and when you call them out on it, they're like, no, you're miserable. You know, they start calling you names. I read an article earlier. It was called 5 Traits of Stupid People, or 5 Habits of Stupid People. And every one of them was so fucking true. I'm sorry. I mean, and I used to think, I'm not going to talk about stupid people. Because when I say that, I'm not talking about people who are mentally handicapped, but rather people who choose to be mentally deficient. People who are morons for the sake of being morons, who know better, but act like fucking children. And there's so many of them out there. I mean, grown adults, they're in our cabinet positions. They're in our government. They are in... They're mayors, you know, and governors, and lawyers, and teachers, and priests, you know? There's so many fucking douchebags in this world. It's just disgusting to me. All this shit that's going on right now with this whole, you know, the Weinstein thing and what it opened up, I think it's wonderful. I say let all those pervy dudes just fucking rot, because, you know, I know that people use the excuse of, well, it's always been that way, the good old days, you grab a chick's ass... Total fucking bullshit. That's a total cop-out. I'll tell you, you know, I have a respect for people's space. That includes women and men. You know, I won't even put an animal out or be harsh to an animal. It's like, I respect all life and all people's and creatures' space. And when it comes to men treating women like objects, it's just disgusting to me. I mean, it's... Pervy dudes are gross. And I'm one of the few guys, unfortunately, that feel that way, it seems. You know, I feel like I'm in a small group of guys who aren't sexually driven. Because if you are really inclined to have any type of a deeper understanding of life, you have to think from the neck up, not with the waist down. If you're thinking with your dick, you're a moron. Because it's time to move past that. You know, you grow up. You go through your puberty stage. And grow up and be a man. And when you're a man in a power position, you don't grow up women. It's disgusting. You know, the most, you know, interesting thing is, of course, Trump, you know, tweeted about Al Franken today. And usually I don't talk about politics, but since I'm rambling about random shit, you know. He tweeted something harsh about Al Franken's little perv incident with groping a woman and forcibly kissing her. And my first thought, I was just sitting there today thinking about that. This is coming from the president who was caught on tape saying, oh, when I see a beautiful woman, I just kiss her. I don't even ask. That was what the fucker literally said. I mean, Donald Trump is the biggest piece of fucking shit to ever walk the earth, as far as I'm concerned. And I know people still look up to the guy. They think he's a hero. He's not. He's what real men think of as a piece of shit. A man who never grew up. A baby. I mean... All you have to do is look at all of the memes of him and see how many have a baby in them. It shows how many people really think of him as a whining child. And it's like, as a guy who grew up and had rough times in my life, you know, and had went through a lot of shit, mentally and otherwise, and broke, you know, growing up not having a lot of money and thinking of these rich douchebags. I never liked Trump, and then all of a sudden he's president, and now people look up to him and try to convince me that he's revereable. And he's just garbage. I mean, he's probably going to end up leaving office, like, crying and gray with the lowest approval rating of any president in history because nobody likes him. But it's not because they're not giving him a chance. It's because people like him are the representative of what's going on, what's wrong with our culture. I think what's happening is citizens are taking out their frustration on the asshole president, rather, by calling out all these other men who have done the similar things to show that it's not okay. Like, if you can't get the boss, you know, get the rest of them. And I'm just loving it. I'm loving it. I don't pay attention to what's going on. I don't follow Hollywood. And I don't give a shit if it falls apart. But I do revel in the idea of all the men in history who have ever abused women getting called out. You know? And there's probably a couple dudes out there who are one of those guys. There's at least one guy watching this who is that guy. And I'm not going to say anything harsh, but rather, you know, please respect other people. You know, other people's space. Women are not here for your pleasure. You know, and maybe there's not a guy out there watching this that feels that way. But it's not just men. There are some women who are so brainwashed into thinking that that's their role, that they fulfill it. You know, it works both ways. And it's not that the women are always to blame. No, the men are far more often to blame. And I'm not a man hater, obviously. But, you know, I just had to bring that up since it's a very relevant topic right now in society. That's how I feel about it. Anyway. Who am I to judge, right? I don't. There's an old saying, like, he who is quick to judge. Actually, that's one of the signs of the least intelligent people, the stupid people, was that they're quick to judge and unlikely to budge in their ways of thinking. That if you present them with new facts, they won't even listen to them. They'll just tell you, you're an idiot, and usually resort to an ad hominem attack, and I'm sure you all have somebody like that. I know people who we can have a debate, and if I call them out on something that's not true, and say, you know, that it's ridiculous, they'll go back to something I'd said before, or resort to anything but talking about the subject. And that's a fallacy and a fallacious argument, but, you know, what do I know? I'm just a human being, you know. Everybody argues. I want to see how much time's elapsed here. I got this little recorder. It's a Tascam D. Let's see what we got. It's getting there. 18 minutes. It's a Tascam DR05. It has like two little microphones on it. It's really cool. I use it for recording music or my thoughts or whatever, and sometimes for recording the audio on these videos, since when I upload one, I just erase it. They take up too much space to save on a computer or an SD card, and plus I don't really need to go back in the future. If YouTube falls apart and I lose all my videos, then so be it. Yeah. My hair is getting long, you may notice. I've actually always had short hair in my videos for the last 7 years, and I finally just decided to let it go. I'm going with the no-poo method, as they call it. It's where you don't shampoo your hair at all. And it's funny how we were always brought up to think, you know, you've got to shampoo, you've got to wash. I'll tell you how I figured this out. I was so programmed to think that, you know, I took daily showers when I was young, even in my hippie stage. I loved to be clean, you know. And my pits some mornings just sweat like crazy, and most of the time they don't. It's only when I use soap in my armpits, and it was only through recent studies on microbial activity that I realized that I have my own microbes that protect my pits and eat that sweat, that if you wash your pits and you use pit stick every day, then you're forced to do that. It's something you have to continuously do, and you will perspire more and you will stink more. It's just a fact. I mean, I've talked to so many people who have had this experience. Generally, I don't wash my armpits, and I don't use any antiperspirant, I don't use any deodorant, and I don't stink unless I've been eating something funky. You can tell by your diet if you've been, you know. So if you do, some people have glandular problems, etc. That's different, but you know, if you're one of those people. But the average person doesn't need to use pit stick, and you don't need to use shampoo. And it'll take about a month for your hair to get adapted to it and get used to it, because it may produce excess oil at first. It may seem dirty, but go ahead and Google it. Look it up, you know, go on YouTube and look at the no shampoo people. The hair is healthier, it grows faster, smoother, you know. Why do we have to wash what nature perfected, you know? Animals wash themselves, but they don't use soap, you know? So the whole idea is you still wash, you just don't use soap. And it makes total sense. In some areas, the water's really bad, so I guess that would be a different story. But anyway, this video's getting pretty long, and I've been rambling about bullshit in my life, but I just had to get it out and just talk about some stuff. I'm going to part ways. I'll show you a picture I'm working on here. It's just for fun with markers, but it has a mushroom with the sun, and I'm gradually coloring in the rays, and it's gonna, it has the mycelium below the ground. And what I'm going to do is when it's finished, I'm going to fill it in with a very small, fine pen and make it super detailed, and I think it'll look pretty sweet, so we'll see. I'm the kind of dude who, like, I'm not an artist, I'm just a guy who likes to draw and paint that leaves shit half finished. That's my thing, so I'll talk to y'all later, and I hope y'all have a wonderful night, and thanks for watching, for what it's worth, right? Peace.